Hello and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Christina. I'm 33 years old. I have a 21 month old son and I make videos related to cleaning, cooking, testing out new products and also living on a budget because I love shopping, I love buying, but I hate spending. So I try to make clever decisions about my purchases. I would love for you to stick around and subscribe if you like my videos. Also, give them a thumbs up if you think they're any good. Give them a thumbs down if you don't like them. And hit me up in the comments telling me what type of videos you would like to see in the future on this channel. I'm sorry for being absent such a long time from this channel. The reason is that I've had all sorts of personal stuff that I had to deal with, and also I have a channel, a Romanian channel, that I will link below in case there are any of you who speak Romanian and who would also like to follow me there. And on that channel I've been more active, but now I'm trying to kick off this channel as well with today's video, which I hope you will like. And the theme for today's video is perfumes, and not just any kind of perfumes, but budget-friendly ones, which also smell amazing. Actually, these perfumes that I'm going to be talking about today are copies, dupes, replicas, clones, whatever you want to call them, of high-end designer perfumes. Of course, I got them in Lidl, which is the store that I visit most often recently. And these are the perfumes. They are called Essence by Suddenly. I only picked up three, but they carry more. I think they carry about 8 of them. In the shop that I visited when I bought these, they did not have all of them. And of course, I sniffed them all, but I only selected those of them that did not smell cheap, that did not smell like a copy, that did not smell like a replica. Of course, it's just my opinion. Maybe some of you might think that the other ones smell good too. I didn't get that. I only selected these three ones that I think make really good designer perfume dupes. They had, for instance, copies for Mugler's Alien, which I didn't think smelled that good, so I did not see the point in buying it. They also had a dupe for Narciso Rodriguez for her, which I already have a copy of, which is this Zara Bright Rose, so I really didn't need to get it. And a special mention here for another dupe, which you can find in Lidl, which is this Suddenly Madame Glamour, which is a copy of Coco Mademoiselle by Chanel. It's a great copy. If you find it in the store, just get it. It's an absolute wonderful copy. I'm using it for quite a while now and I've got nothing but compliments on it. Also, this one is a permanent product that you can find in the store, while these Essence ones you can only find on special occasions like Valentine's Day or other special days throughout the year. So these are not available all the time. When you see them, just pick them up if you like them. Enough talking, let's get into today's video, which are these three perfumes. And I'm gonna try to give you an honest opinion about them. I bought them a while ago, so I've had the time to use them and get an impression, I would say an informed impression about them. So let me just take them one by one in no particular order. So I will start from my left to my right. So let's start with this Essence d'Amour by Suddenly, which is an eau de parfum of 100ml bottle. In my opinion, the packaging looks really nice, really classy, really elegant. This is cardboard, but it used to have a plastic wrap around it. I, of course, threw it away. This is what the bottle looks like, and in my opinion, it's very impressive. It looks really elegant, really high class. I would say it's quite fantastic. The cap is transparent. And the whole ensemble looks really nice with all this degradé red here. This Essence de Amour is a copy of Cacharel's Amour Amour. I will state from the beginning that I never had the original, the Amour Amour, but my sister had it, so I'm quite familiar with the fragrance. I will try to give you my opinion on three points about this perfume. First, the similarity to the original perfume. Second, its persistence, so how long it lasts. And third, its sillage. I think this is the international term that is used for how long of a distance this perfume radiates. When you first sniff it, you get a hint of alcohol, but it's not really powerful, so that makes it seem like a good quality perfume, so you don't get tons and tons of alcohol for like a whole minute. You just get it for a few seconds, but it goes away really fast. And as time progresses, the scent becomes more and more similar to its original counterpart, to Amour Amour of Cacharel. In terms of similarity of the fragrance, I would rate this an 8.5 up to a 9 out of 10. In terms of persistence, of course, this is not as long-lasting as the original one. I would say this lasts a good 3, maybe up to 4 hours on me, but not more. I would have to reapply it every 3 to 4 hours. That doesn't bother me, of course, but for some people it may be disturbing to have to reapply it, carry it around with them. I would give it, in terms of persistence, 7.5 up to an 8. Out of 10. So it's not bad, but it's not the greatest either. Let's also talk about the sillage of this perfume. So how long of a distance it radiates. I would say it's it doesn't fill up a room when you enter it, of course, but people like an arm's length around you will be able to feel it. So I would probably rate it about 6.5-7 out of 10 in terms of sillage. If I were to rate it as a whole, overall, I would rate this perfume an 8 to a 9 out of 10. Because the fragrance is more important to me than the persistence and the sillage. So I would give it maybe a 9 out of 10, which in my opinion makes a very, very good copy of Cacharel's Amour Amour. The price is less than 5 euros, which you cannot beat. If I were to offer this perfume as a present, I would probably not do it, because I know that I bought it for really cheap, but for myself, bring it on. I will definitely use it up. I will buy it again and again, and I'm loving this copy. It's a great perfume, in my opinion. It's a great fragrance. Okay, let's move on to the next one, which is this Essence de Agua Marina by Suddenly. This is a dupe for Acqua di Gioia by Giorgio Armani. The packaging looks similar to the other one, it's just that this one is green and it gives you a very aquatic, nautical feeling. You just open it. It's also an eau de parfum for 100ml bottle. And this is what the bottle looks like. Very similar to the Essence de Amour. It's just that instead of red, we have this very pale green color, which I love. I think it looks high class. It shows off elegance. It's absolutely amazing. I love it. Let me just spritz it so we can talk about the first impression that it gives out. There's very, very little alcohol fragrance that you can feel. Very, very little. I would say it's even less than the Amour Amour, which makes it seem like a pretty high-end fragrance. It does not give out that impression of cheap. fragrance. So it makes it quite classy. In terms of similarity to the original, I would say it's very good. I would rate it 9.5 out of 10. So it's really, really similar to the original one. And the fact that it does not give off the alcohol, that makes it an even bigger plus. In terms of persistence, I would say, just like it was the case for the Amor Amor copy, the persistence is not great. I would say I would have to reapply it every also 3 to 4 hours, but that's just on me. And of course, the persistence of a smell on somebody will depend on the pH of the skin of that person. So this one lasts about 3 to 4 hours on me, which will make me give it about an 8.5 out of 10. And also, in terms of sillage, it's not bad, but it's not great either. It's better than medium. I would probably give it about 7.5. So overall, I would rate this fragrance 9.5 out of 10. I think this fragrance is a really, really good copy of Acqua di Gioia by Giorgio Armani. Same as for the copy of Amor Amor, I would not offer it to anybody, but I would definitely use it and reuse it for myself. I love this perfume. It's elegant, it's classy, it does not give off a cheap hint. It's a great copy and it's a great buy. It's really money well spent. And the last fragrance that I picked up is this Essence Anne Rose, which is a copy of La Vie Belle. I read online while researching this perfume, some people say it smells just like Flower Bomb by Victor and Rolf. I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't know that perfume. I never had it, I never smelled it. I'm gonna stick to comparing it to La Vie Belle by Lancôme, which is a perfume that I know. Also, I didn't have it, but I'm quite familiar with it. When you first spritz it, I would say it gives off more of an alcohol fragrance than the other two. So when you first smell it, like the very first second that you spritzed it, it smells a little bit more like a cheap copy. But as soon as it sets in and it dries out, the actual La Vie Belle fragrance sets in and you just discovers it, it reveals itself to you, and I'm telling you, it's a wonder. It smells very, very, very similar to the original La Vie Belle. I would rate it a 9.5 out of 10. I think the similarity is impressive. It's, I would say, fantastic. I really like it. In terms of persistence, it behaves way better than the other two. For me, it lasts about 8-9 hours. Just a quick story here. I spritzed it on yesterday on my wrist, and I washed my hands with soap about 4 or 5 times, including the wrist, and the perfume still smelled. So I'm telling you, this in terms of persistence is great. I would probably give it a 10 out of 10 in terms of persistence. It's absolutely great in my opinion, for a copy, of course. Let's talk about sillage. It's better than the other two, I would say, but it's not as great as the original ones. I would probably give it an 8.5 out of 10. So overall, this Essence Anne Rose by Suddenly is a great, impressive copy of La Vie Belle, in my opinion. I would rate it overall 9.5, maybe even a 9.8 out of 10. It's a great smell, a great persistence, good sillage, and the bottle looks elegant, classy, high-end. I absolutely love it. Also, I wouldn't give this to anybody as a gift, but for myself, It's absolutely perfect. I'm sure that when this one is used up, I will definitely buy a new bottle. And to be honest with you, I have no reason to buy any of the original three fragrances. These copies just do the deal. If you've followed me so far, I hope you enjoyed my video. I would like to restate that this is just my opinion and this is how these perfumes smell on me. I hope you found this useful and informative. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, just give it a thumbs down. Tell me in the comments what type of video you would like to see in the future. If you're new, please consider subscribing. I would like to have you around for longer. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye-bye!